I would like to appeal to you, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, to learn some Arabic, to learn the basic Arabic. Because wallahi, if you don't learn Arabic, you are deprived from the most powerful tool that Allah Jalla Ala sent to humanity. You are deprived from the biggest rahmah, the biggest mercy that Allah Jalla Ala sent to humanity. You are actually deprived from the light that Allah Jalla Ala sent to humanity, which is Al-Quran Al-Kareem. Because you see, you cannot understand what Allah Jalla Ala is saying.
وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض أعدت للمتقين الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم ذكروا الله فاستغفروا لذنوبهم ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ولم يصروا على ما فعلوا وهم يعلمون أولئك جزاؤهم مغفرة من ربهم وجنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها ونعم أجر العاملين قد خلت من قبلكم سنن فسيروا في الأرض فانظروا كيف كان عاقبة المكذبين هذا بيان للناس وهدى وموعظة للمتقين ولا تهنوا ولا تحزنوا وأنتم الأعلون إن كنتم مؤمنين إن يمسسكم قرح فقد مس القوم قرح مثله وتلك الأيام نداولها بين الناس وليعلم الله الذين آمنوا ويتخذ منكم شهداء والله لا يحب الظالمين وليمحص الله الذين آمنوا ويمحق الكافرين أم حسبتم أن تدخلوا الجنة ولما يعلم الله الذين جاهدوا منكم ويعلم الصابرين ولقد كنتم تمنون الموت من قبل أن تلقوه فقد رأيتموه وأنتم تنظرون وما محمد إلا رسول قد خلت من قبله الرسل أفإن مات أو قتل انقلبتم على أعقابكم ومن ينقلب على عقبيه فلن يضر الله شيئا وسيجزي الله الشاكرين.
Who understood the verses that Imam read? Just raise your hand. Who understood the verses the Imam read? So I guess maybe 1%, 2%, yeah, maximum. Subhanallah, brothers and sisters, to be honest with you, I was planning to speak about other verses, but the power of those verses compelled me to speak about them. So powerful. Yet, before I speak about those verses, I would like to appeal to you, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, to learn some Arabic, to learn the basic Arabic. Because wallahi, if you don't learn Arabic, you are deprived from the most powerful tool that Allah Jalla Ala sent to humanity. You are deprived from the biggest rahmah, the biggest mercy that Allah Jalla Ala sent to humanity. You are actually deprived from the light that Allah Jalla wa Ala sent to humanity, which is Al-Quran Al-Kareem. Because you see, you cannot understand what Allah Jalla wa Ala is saying. And Al-Hasan ibn Ali, he said the example of understanding the meanings of the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala is like the example of some people who are lost, either in a desert, in a very dark place, they don't know where to go. And then a letter came to them showing them the instructions, what to do in this dark situation, in this terrible situation. Will those people be happy? Will they settle before being able to read those instructions? I'm asking you, brothers, what do you think? Imagine an emergency situation that happened at home. Once in my home, I woke up and there is a leak. Leak. Water leak. And now I just panicked because the leak upstairs, I have a very bad experience of previous leaks where almost the entire house was damaged because of the leak. I went for a holiday. And you know how bad that situation is if you have ever experienced that. Now, I was panicking and I want to know where is the valve, the main valve, so I lock it up. Imagine if there is an instruction, a piece of instruction to how to act when there is an emergency situation like this. And this instruction, I will be panicking, looking for it. Imagine a situation where much worse than this. You will be so desperate to understand what the instruction is saying. This is the situation of the ummah. This is the situation of the individual who is what? Living without understanding the basic meanings of the Quran, brothers. Wallahi. Yes, brothers, shall we change this attitude and try to learn the basic meanings of the Quran? Inshallah. And don't think that it is difficult. Many people, they have a mental barrier between them and learning the basic meanings of the Quran. If you try and you start, it will be very easy. وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرٍ Allah Jalla wa'ala revealed the Quran, spoke the Quran, and Allah Jalla wa'ala revealed it to be easy for those who want to learn it, for those who want to reflect upon it. And some of the researchers, they said that you need to learn the meanings of 100 words, 100 basic words of the Quran. And once you learn those 100 words, that will enable you to understand, I think they said 50% of the general meanings of the Quran. Yes, brothers? So don't think that it is a very difficult thing. No, it is easy. Okay, the verses that the Imam read, subhanAllah, so powerful. Those verses, if you really understand Arabic, you will see that those verses are talking about our situation now. And you know the challenges the Ummah is going through these days. The best way to deal with those challenges is to open the Mus'haf and to see what instructions Allah Jalla wa'ala has given us to deal with those challenges. Among the verses the Imam read, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ This is a principle in your life, a very fundamental principle, which is what? Be so hasty in doing good deeds. Why? Because you are actually so hasty for what? When you are so hasty in doing good deeds, you will be so hasty in what? In getting the forgiveness of Allah Jalla wa'ala and what? Getting into Jannah. So actually doing so many good deeds, being so hasty in doing good deeds, you are not doing any favor except for who? For yourself. For yourself, because you are getting closer to Jannah and the forgiveness of Allah Jalla wa'ala. And then Allah Jalla wa'ala explained, gave some instructions or some description of the muttaqi. Then Allah Jalla wa'ala mentioned another fundamental principle that we need to maintain in our life, which is what? وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْنَ إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ Subhanallah, this verse, if you translate it and you put it on your mobile phone as one of your guidelines, life guidelines, which is what? Don't be saddened. Don't feel low. Don't be down. Don't be depressed. Don't be pessimistic. Not only that. وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا Sadness is not from Islam. What? Islam is not commanding us to be sad? No. In fact, Islam is against what? Against sadness and grief. Islam wants everyone to be, the minimum to be happy, to be confident, optimistic, positive, up. Ya Rabbi, what about those atrocities that we see around us? Look at what happened. What is happening to our brothers and sisters in Gaza, in Sudan. Yesterday, the report was saying that there are around 7 million people who are displaced and living in a very terrible situation, maybe as terrible or maybe more terrible than the people of Gaza. They don't find anything to eat or to drink. and they are just thrown in the desert. They don't even have any piece of clothes that will shelter them against the heat there, yeah, against the heat of the sun. Women, children, elderly people. Ya Rabbi, you don't want me to be sad when I see these things. How come? Let alone the personal problems that I go through. I lost my father. You don't want me to be sad. I lost my children. I have cancer. I have this. I have all these atrocities. You don't want me to be sad? Yes, you might feel sad temporarily. But as a long term, no. Why? Because the point is, as far as you are a believer, you are what? You are uplifted. You are optimistic. You are up. Because of what? Because of your iman. Because you know that these atrocities that and those challenges, no matter how horrible they are, they will lead you what? They will lead you to what, brothers and sisters? To Jannah. In fact, to a high place in Jannah because of what? Because of the atrocities, because of the challenges, because of the sabr, the patience you have shown, because of the acceptance of the decree of Allah Jalla Ala that you have shown. Wallahi, just remembering this verse, my dear brothers and sisters, puts so much peace and tranquility in your heart. Subhanallah, the rest of the ayat are amazing. Amazing. But because we don't want to take much time in commenting on the verses after Fajr, I'll stop here. Otherwise, my heart doesn't allow me really to stop at this point because of the richness of those verses. I appeal to you, brothers. Go, please, let us do this practice. Don't just listen to the maw'idah, etc., without putting an effort yourself to benefit from the lesson, from the reminder, from the verses of the Quran. I appeal to you to go today. Those verses, they are from Surah Ali Imran. Yeah? We have Surah Al-Fatiha, Al-Baqarah, and Ali Imran. I think they start at verse number 101. Yeah? Read the meanings of those verses with your wife, with your children, if possible. Call them for a few minutes. Reflect upon those verses. May Allah Jalla Ala accept it from all of you. Jazakumullahu khairan.